Went ahead and got myself a new knife. So, without further presentation, here it is, my new Samii knife. The Samii knife for Stuorniibi, or whatever how they say it. Means large knife. In Finland they call this Lapin Leuku, or just Leuku. So it is a big knife. Mine is from Knivsmed, Strømeng. And this is the largest knife in the line. Now they come in 9-inch blades like this, or 8-inch. Which is more common, more popular, and 7-inch, which is considered a lady's knife. Those three models come in carbon steel, like this one, while the 5-inch and 3.5-inch children's knives come in stainless steel. As you can see, the sheet for it is quite simple. The whole knife goes in. I made a small modification there with a cheap carabiner, just to make it easier to attach to my belt or a belt loop, or to my backpack, like that. The Samii knife, it was, and still is, used by the Samii. This is the Samii multi-tool. This is a true multi-tool. You use it for everything. Chopping poles for your tarp or your tent. Splitting bones, slaughtering, gutting fish. Cutting meat. Slicing bread. You use it to chop wood. You can even dig with it. Norwegian army soldiers are issued a special version, which is 8 inches and has a finger guard. You just notice the lack of a finger guard on this. That's because this is a grown-up's knife. So when you're a grown-up, you're expected to know how to use a knife. Not cut yourself. Now that is coming from somebody who should be kept away from anything sharper than boiled lettuce. So we'll see. It is quite a big knife, as I said. Just compare it to this is the Mora 7-Eleven. So. You have something for comparison. You just put that away. The knife has quite a history. It also has some, according to the Sami or Sami tradition, it has some magical properties as well. That's mainly because of this. This is brass. All Sami knives have, or should have, so an element of brass in it. The brass is considered holy, and a Sami knife can stop blood, nice if you cut yourself, for removing boils, and also to prevent bad luck, and so this is a true protection device. Let's just stop talking, and I'll try to put it through some tests.
Two or three fingers.
One or two fingers behind.
And you put one or two fingers behind the pommel. Now this is the way
to hold it when chopping. Just put one or two fingers behind the pommel.
And you got a longer, you know, the lever principle, the lever principle, how you say that. Nice chopping there. See, now this is straight from the factory, so straight from the factories. So that was the chopping done. Hope I could catch that on film. Let's see. Now I'm going to do something I don't like to do to any kind of blade, not even this one, but okay. And that is buttoning. Normally I'll use an axe for that. You can try. So so as you can see, it can button. That's it for that. And while we're at it, let's try to feather stick with it. Thank you.
as you can see, it can feather stick. No problem. Probably that the blade is so thin helps. It's only a 3 millimeter stick, which makes for an extremely light knife. It's no problem to walk around with this in your belt. Your trousers won't fall off. Very, very light. Partially it's due to the thin blade. It's got a rat tail tang, I think it's V-shaped like that, all the way to the end of the pommel. The handle is birch on this one. It can be antler, reindeer antler. And they also make a deluxe model with the... yeah, if I could remember the name of it, I'll tell you, some kind of birch. Yeah, not much more to tell you. I don't know. This is a beautiful knife to work with. Yeah, for gutting fish, for example. Just hold it like that. Work it like that. you get the idea. It's a wonderful knife. Of course, you will always need a smaller blade. But this is for the large part going to replace my small hatchet. Most of the time, I don't need the hatchet. Probably going to put a patina on it to protect it, so it's carbon steel. Blade is the edge is still, the Scandi grind is still perfect after all of that. I was lucky with this one. I got a good discount on it because the blade has some patina on it already. It's been a story. I've been eyeing this knife for a long time. Just didn't want to fork out for it because they are expensive, you know. At least I think they are expensive. It was just a little bit too much. I had a hatchet and I had some other knives, but you just got the, if you're Norwegian and you like to be outdoors, you just have to have one of these.